Patrick Mahomes has got the better of Lamar Jackson head-to-head in their careers. Mahomes has won 5 of 6 contests, and Patty Mahomes passing Len Dawson for the most passing yards in KC franchise history in 86 fewer games. Despite the loss, Lamar Jackson moved past Russell Wilson for third most rushing yards by a quarterback in NFL history. And joining me right now from Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, it is none other than Farhan Lalji, one of my best buddies at the network. Farhan, they say football is a game of inches. This final play came down to about an inch, a toe on the line. Did you think it was the right play call for the Baltimore Ravens?
Well, first of all, I want to tell you that it was right here, like right here. See, like that, like kind of like that. It was like that. That's how close it was, right on that spot. We bring you the best here on JNSC. But look, I'm not sure that it was the right call. And quite frankly, I don't know that it matters. And I say that only because I thought no matter what, Lamar Jackson was going to find a way to scramble and take this in for a touchdown and just keep the ball in his hands. Now, I'm not sure if what happened on the previous play, he wasn't going to scramble at that point because they had no timeouts left. And, you know, you weren't going to risk that there. But he misses a wide open Zay Flowers. So I don't know if that kind of gave him some conviction that no matter what, I'm going to throw it here. But on that final play, he ran for his life like he did so often in the second half of this game. Gets the ball to Isaiah Likely. Nick Bolton with the play to knock it out of bounds. And, you know, bang, bang call. They did a good job with review. Ultimately, I think they got it right. So in terms of what the actual play design was, I don't know that we can say it was the right or the wrong play because it didn't turn out to be the play as it was designed. I, again, thought Lamar Jackson would keep the ball in his hands like he did so many times in the second half of that game. But ultimately saw something in Likely, tried to get it to him. And look, he made a number of big plays throughout this game. He was kind of the one surprise in this game with the 9 receptions. He had a dozen targets. Not many people knew who Isaiah Likely was until this game, so he certainly earned Lamar Jackson's trust. But wow, just a bizarre play and a game of inches.
And you alluded to it. Lamar Jackson kept the football for a lot of the second half, finished with 122 rushing yards, moves into third all-time in NFL history among quarterbacks in rushing yards, only behind Mike Vick and Cam Newton. Pretty impressive stats. But the question I have for you, Farhan, is do you think this type of offense is sustainable for the Baltimore Ravens?
No chance. And I don't know that Lamar Jackson can get to the halfway point of the season if this has to continue to be the way they play offense. I'm sitting here taking notes as I'm going through the last two drives, and basically every play was Lamar pulls, Lamar scrambles, Lamar avoids the rush and throws the ball. 16 rushes in this game for 122 yards. Not just more rushing yards than he had, more attempts than he had in any game last season. And coming into this, you know, there was some conversation about trying to remove some of the designed runs from the offensive repertoire, maybe have Derrick Henry take a little bit more of that load because you knew that Jackson was still going to do some things organically. But I heard Luke Wilson talk about it, that it was recess football, backyard football, and it certainly looked like that. Todd Monken couldn't find anything going here. They tried to find different ways to get Zay Flowers the football. I think Trent McDuffie did a masterful job on him, so they did a number of things in the screen game and get him across the formation. Whatever Monken tried, it didn't work, so really it fell to Lamar Jackson to run around and try to make things happen. And in terms of Derrick Henry, tonight at least, it felt like square peg, round hole in terms of how they like to run the football. We'll see what happens as this thing evolves going forward.
And then as far as the Chiefs are concerned, the big story has to be the rookie, Xavier Worthy. We heard about his combine time. We knew he was speedy. I don't know if we expected 2 touchdowns in his NFL debut. Were you surprised that this rookie made such an impact for the defending champs?
Well, I'm surprised they didn't try to give him the football more. And I know we got a lot of Buffalo Bills fans watching right now, and they're getting dunked on because they're getting criticized for how they were able to let Xavier Worthy fall to the Kansas City Chiefs in the draft when you look at the needs that Buffalo had in their receiving core. But look, this guy is fast. You mentioned the 40 time at the combine, and there was some concern going into the draft and whether or not he was durable enough, physical enough. He's still a very slight player, but when he gets the ball in his hands, it is breathtaking to watch, much like a guy named Tyreek Hill did earlier when he was a Kansas City Chief. Now, Hill was a little thicker and could maybe take a little bit more of the pounding. We'll see if Worthy can do that, but it's not just the 3 touches. It's when he's out there, what that has the capability of doing to a defense. I know in the preseason, he only got 23 snaps in the preseason, but every time he was out there, it just seemed like a second or a third defender made their way over Xavier Worthy, and it opened up things for other receivers. So when you look at Kansas City, they've still got some things to work through. A few more drops than I'm sure they would like, considering what they went through a year ago. But they've got this shiny new toy in Xavier Worthy, and as long as they learn how to take advantage of him in a number of different ways, I think the sky's the limit for this offense.
What a fun game for you to be at and to cover. And now you get to go to San Francisco, and you get to see Aaron Rodgers and the Jets and the Niners. How great is your life, Farhan Walji?
My life is so good. You know, my 12-year-old daughter, though, thinks I'm a bit of a bum because I couldn't get Taylor Swift to maybe do a video message for her. So she's pretty disappointed about that. But other than that, the other parts of my life are quite good, especially when I get to talk to you. Jay.
Jay, but it's not really important. A star of your magnitude doesn't need to know my name. That's not important. Travel safe to the Bay Area, okay, my friend? Great chatting with you. We'll talk to you on Monday night.
See you, buddy.